A very good morning and welcome to the first episode of Carpool Podcast, Learning on the Go. This is a weekly podcast featuring 10 minutes of content on business, relationship and personal growth that you can consume on the go. And this is your host, Hugo Tan, and our guest for today is Mr. David Lee, an avid networker, a member of BNI Benchmark, former president of Road Track Kuala Lumpur, blogger at Urban Inspire Insights, and a consultant at ACT Hubs. Please welcome Mr. David Lee.
Hi, David Lee here. Thanks for the kind introduction about me. So here I have 8 points to talk about the networking tips. So let's start with the first one. Parents also know that we need to get ready before the networking session. So the first 3 points will be talking about the getting ready of a networking session. So first point is know your intention when you want to go to the networking session. Maybe it's like a casual networking session. Maybe you go there just to talk to your friends, or is it that this is a really like a business kind of networking place event? So you will get ready of your intention first, like how long you want to be there and how many name cards, how many people you want to contact, you want to collect, and you must know your intention first. So the first one, know your intention. Right? You go there for fun, for network, or want to give as much name card as you want, you must know your objective first before you go there. So that's the first point. Number 2 point is dress code. So dress code is like it's same as the intention one. With dress code, you must know your dress code, about if you need to wear a coat or if it's a casual or casual wear, things like that. So number 2 is the dress code. You must know your all these 2 points first before you go there. And number 3, you must know you must get ready for your grooming. About this is really easy. I mean, it is common sense for salespeople. You must, as a man, you must get ready your mustache, everything. You must get it nice and grooming properly, and get your business attire accordingly as well. So I also get your name cards ready. That is the 3rd point. Your name cards also, if you don't have name cards, get ready with an e-name card in your WhatsApp or in your mobile phone. So that one, if sometimes we finish our name cards, you only have one name card only, then or whatever, you have finished your name cards, you can use the e-name card to send the person right away on the spot. So get ready of these 3 things. So the 4th point is don't go there just to be a salesperson, just to meet as just throw your name cards to people. You must be like a connector. Be a connector whereby when you're talking to people, try to know their story. Whether when you talk to them, you want to know why they joined the business. There's a few questions make you stand up, because sometimes you talk to people, they felt like not listening to them. So it's better. One of the points I always use in networking is like, why you join this business? Then also, what you do before this business? So you get to know the person more. You want to know the background a bit more. Then after that, after they talk about their past or their why they joined the business, then get to know what they're really looking for their business, what's a new project. So when they talk about new projects, they'll get excited. They will know what to tell you, the new project, new marketing skill, want to try out something. Then at the back of your mind, you are a connector. You try to connect them to your contacts. So you're not here to sell your product to them. You try to connect them to your existing contacts, or maybe you want to collaborate in your own future projects. So that's why the 5th thing is connect them to the right people in your own contacts, or you tell them you have a shared contacts here. You, for example, like a trainer maybe they want to have a looking for working space for training. So you, in the back of your mind, you have some of your business owner having a co-working space. You can collaborate with them. So you can, I know this guy who's doing a carbon ground or something like that. I can share the contact to you. You can connect with me for your training purposes. Or for me, I share the same contact with them as an educational line. So maybe I can talk to them, maybe collaborate with my HR department side of people. I can share my HR contacts with them, and they can share the HR contact to me as a trainer. That's my power team. So you can see the collaboration. Then you must get to know them, kind of connect them with your own contacts, and you share your contacts with them. Number six is create a unique impression to people. So for myself, I have a background with NGO and a background with BNI and other things I'm doing as that make me unique. So you must have one or two things that make you stand out, because over there there's about 100 to 50 people you just talk to people. So most of them have the same thing, don't have any unique thing to talk about. So you must have a unique thing that make them stick to you. When they call them, right, you must, oh, do you know this guy? Do you know me? I'm from BNI. So they will just connect you to the unique thing you tell them. So as Terrence also, he works in NGO, all the stuff, he make you stand out for other the crowd, everyone there. So that's the sixth thing, that unique impression to people. Number seven, is create synergy to your contact. That one is like a boils down to all the points before, whereby you create the, whether you can bring this to outside of the networking session. Maybe you can have a one-to-one coffee or collaboration to an event, you invite them to your event, or you must create synergy during that networking session. Which you need to choose, which maybe for myself, I need to talk to 10 people over there, then I choose about 3 or 5 people I can collect them later on in the future. So you must, back to the intention part in the first point, how many contacts you want to connect to. So because time passed very fast, one, I can tell you. In a networking session, 1 hour, 2 hours, it's gone very fast. So if you talk to one person, you just maybe, I don't say waste your time, but just go back to intention, whether how many people you want to meet to. So that's why you must know when to exceed the, when you're talking to, if let's say you want 10 people. So one person may only talk about 10 minutes, then you can move on to, or 5 minutes maybe the maximum, then you move to the next. If you go there just to have fun, talk to people, just go to one person, just talk about your story, and you're wasting your time in a working session. You need to talk to one or two people, and you need to connect to two people, and it's just wasting your time, in my opinion. So for me, I want to think about talk to 10 quality people in 2 hours time or 1 hour time. So when I talk to 10 people, then I see this guy, okay, maybe we have a shared power team, we have shared contacts, then we can collaborate more. So I spend more time with him. Maybe I connect back before I go back, I will just shake his hand, I say, keep in touch, we can talk later on or next week, we can schedule the time there. So so you must create a synergy to people. That's my point. And number eight, after the networking session end, the day before, the day after, or on that night, you must, if you have time, you do it on that day. I think both of us are busy. I think Dan's also, Hugo also really busy. We only do maybe the first 48 hours. You must do it before they send a reminder to them that you met them this networking session. 48 hours, maybe we are so busy, right, sometimes. So we need 48 hours to do this, done this. So the next thing, this is a more advanced point, which is create a system of business card, because most of us, we throw away our business cards everywhere. So you must create a business card whereby you can categorize all your contacts. So that's the thing you do in your own way. So that's all the 8 points that I have.
Thank you, David. Very interesting points you have shared here. And we realize that you have given a lot of emphasis on being a goal giver versus just a goal taker. As both of us know that many people go into networking with the mindset of what can I get from this and who can I sell this to? Which is not wrong per se, but it would be better at the beginning and for the long run to actually add value in our relationships, to actually invest in our relationship, and to have a mindset of how can I connect to people and what can I add to this relationship. The second point that I learned from your sharing is that networking is not just a random conversation where you walk into a venue or a party or a meeting and you just randomly meet people and distribute name cards. In fact, it is a very intentional method of connecting with people, that you actually go in there with a very clear game plan, a very step-by-step game plan of how you can add value and what you want to achieve from the networking session. And I would like to raise a very common concern, which is for most people that go into networking, they tend to have a very weak to non-existent follow-up. So in your opinion, what are some of the tips that you can share with your audience today on how they can follow up more effectively?
For me, I categorize them in a few sections. Some of them, if I see them as a very senior person, they're like a mentor to me, then I keep their side as this guy, okay, this one, I think I'm the one to take a lot from them, maybe take a lot of knowledge from them, advice from them. They're like, I think I categorize them as mentors. Then there's one part is like maybe the product, I think my product can sell to them. I can sell product to them, and then I categorize them to that level. Then some of them I can see that we can work out something, we can do that. And some of them are friends. So I categorize all this like this. Then after that, when I save the number, right, I will put the way I met them. I will save a note there where I met them. Then what's their in BNI, there's called classification, whereby for me in BNI, my classification is education services. So in my when I save the number, I also save their classification as well. If you're in the insurance line, in which company, ARA, whatever, what they are focusing on. So when I save the number on their phone, I put all the details as much as I can. Sometimes I'm too busy, so I just put short form or a few notes there, enough already. Then after that, I've done all that already, but I must save the way that I met them, categorize them which part I want to follow up with them. As a mentor, maybe if I can add value to them, maybe my business can add value to them, maybe I can share some events that I know, because most people come here, they want to network a lot. So I will tell them, I know this place who can network, maybe I can show to you. So I give something to the my mentor, maybe I will meet them in the future, or anybody want to, I want to connect with more, right? I will tell them, I know some other events I will share to you, maybe I share to you, I give something to them first. So they will say, oh, this guy is really good, so I can connect them again. So I give something to them, like tips or whatever to give to them, then you can follow up with them back.
I love it. I love the fact that you categorize the people that you meet into potential mentors, business partners, or clients, instead of just the regular classification according to industry and what is it that they do. To sum it up, for the benefit of the audience who wants to connect with you, perhaps you can share a bit about your work in ACT Hubs. What is it that you do there? And who do you look forward to collaborate or to work together?
So ACT Hubs, we are in the education line. We are educational provider. Well, our core product is called industry sponsorship program, whereby our student after Form 5, they join our diploma program, diploma in business management, diploma in hospitality management, or diploma in commercial management. They study for one day on Saturday. Then on the Monday to Friday, they have an internship program to those employers. So employers, actually, they sponsor their college fees, things like that. So it's a win-win to all of everyone. The employers will get the manpower. The student will get sponsorship from the employers, they pay their college fees. So it's a win-win to all. So these are our core products. So right now, we're looking for hotel sponsor. Maybe like a 4 or 5 star hotel that we can partner with for the hotel management program that we currently gonna have established very soon. By July, we have a class for hotel management. So we are seeking out a hotel sponsor right now, hotel employers. Thank you.
Thank you, David. I think that's all the time we have for the Carpool Podcast Learning on the Go, Episode 1. So today we are very grateful because we've hear it from a good networker himself, Mr. Lee, on the 8 best tips that you can take home today on how you can network better and build better connections and have better relationships that actually continue to add value to the ecosystem. As the saying goes, your network is your net worth. So have a good day.